Hello everyone and welcome to Neverwinter, or as I like to call it, DDN. I've been playing for a few weeks now in the open beta, got up to level 20. So, in my experience so far, I've seen that different races and different classes work really well together. So, I thought I'd do a video explaining a bit about the races and classes. So, we're going to jump straight in with Human. Now, Human, as with all games, is a very versatile class. You can use him with a lot of different things. He does have some advantages, though, with certain classes. One of the classes I'd say he's got an advantage with is the Guardian Warrior sort of guy. He's the tank in the team. Now, the reason for this is he's got Versatile Defense. Versatile Defense gives you a 3% increase to your defense rating, which is obviously really good if you're going to be absorbing all the damage for the rest of the team. His abilities give you +2 to any ability, so you can pick from Constitution, Strength, Wisdom, Charisma, Dexterity, any of them. So that's good for all-round classes. You can basically hit anyone and still get a stat bonus. Heroic Effect, again, it's not really a class-specific thing. It helps absolutely everyone. So if you're unsure on what you want to play, Human is one of the good choices. Now we're going to move on to Elf. The Wood Elves, as they're actually called, I'm completely wrong. I would say they're not bad at tricks to rogue. Now the reason for this is they get a critical strike increase of 1%. Never a bad thing when you're going to be jumping around dealing a lot of critical damage. The abilities go to Dexterity, Intelligence, or Wisdom. Dexterity is the main ability used by trickster rogues, so it's important to get a high dexterity score if you want to do really well when you're playing as the rogue. The Wild Step ability gives you a 10% resistance to effects that slow your movement. Very good if you're going to be a trickster rogue. You need to shorten the distance between you and the enemy, and you need to do it really quickly. Okay, so Elf, again, quite a versatile class. You can more or less get away with a lot of things for him. With the ability, you can get away with a cleric, you can get away with a control wizard, you can get away with a trickster rogue. Pretty good all-rounders. Now we're going to move on to the less all-rounders and more class-specific races. So first we're going to go to the Half-Orc. Now looking at this fella, he's big, he's muscly, he's probably got a bit of a beer belly going on there. So you would imagine he's going to be a tank, or he's going to wield a massive sword and just kill things. Well, you couldn't be more wrong. This guy is really good at a trickster rogue. You're going to see this guy jumping around doing pirouettes in the air. Reason for this, Furious Assault. 5% extra damage every time you crit them. Very good for trickster rogues. Trickster rogues are notorious for going around and critting people to death. The ability score gives you +2 dexterity, again as I said earlier, the main stat of a trickster rogue, and +2 to either constitution or +2 to strength. +2 to strength is good because that increases your damage, so you're increasing your damage as a trickster rogue. Swift charge, you gain 10% movement speed, run speed, as they like to call it, when you enter combat. Very good, means you can close that gap I was talking about earlier very quickly. So, even though he can be affected by these anti-movement effects more than an elf, it's still better than nothing. So, if you want to play as a trickster rogue, Half-Orc is a very good choice. Now we move on to the dwarf. These little guys, as normal, and as you might even imagine, are very good guardians. Guardians, obviously being the tanks, have to stand their ground, as one of his abilities is in fact called. The Stand Your Ground ability allows you to... allows you to resist knocks and repel effects. Very good when you're going to be the tank stood in the middle of all the damage and being pushed back. But, well, you would be pushed back, but you're a dwarf. You stand your ground. His abilities are +2 to constitution, +2 to strength, and all wisdom. Now, constitution being the main thing for a guardian is very helpful. Strength obviously increases your damage, which is also helpful. You don't want to be a tank who does no damage, you want to at least do some. So that's very helpful. Cast Iron Stomach allows you to have increased damage resistance against dots. Absolutely fantastic when you're stood in the middle of combat and taking everything. You want to be able to survive as long as possible and keep as many things off of the rest of your team as possible. So you're thinking about playing a Guardian, Dwarf, very good choice in the race selection. Let's move on to the Half-Elf. The Half-Elf, descended from Elves and Humans, obviously as you might tell, it's a bit of an odd class. His ability, or passive, Diligent, grants +1 to all non-class ability score. So basically, if you're playing as a trickster rogue and you need dexterity, this will give +1 to wisdom, charisma, basically what you don't use, what's not your primary or secondaries. Which is a bit odd, probably makes him a bit harder to play, but it's not too, too bad. Ability scores that you can get with him are Constitution, Charisma, and all Wisdom. Constitution is the secondary for great weapon fighters, which is not a bad thing if you want to be a great weapon fighter. So you could possibly want to play a great weapon fighter with this guy. A knack for success means that they get +1% defense, +1% critical severity, and +1 gold. You're going to be getting quite a bit of money as this guy, so he's not too bad for that at least. If anything, I would suggest you played a great weapon fighter with the half elf. Although, again, he's a bit of an odd one. He doesn't really fit into any specific categories. Now let's move on to the halfling. The halfling, as you might imagine, is going to be a trickster rogue, and you're 100% correct. Nimble reaction means he's small and quick. This means he gains a 3% chance to deflect incoming attacks. This is really good, means you can survive a bit longer, and trickster rogues are quite squishy, so it's good to try and give yourself a harder dexterity. His ability scores are +2 to dexterity, +2 to charisma, and +2 to constitution. Dexterity, again, primary for the trickster rogue. This guy is almost perfect. Charisma is also a secondary used by trickster rogues. This guy is almost brilliant for it. Bold, he's fearless, he resists crowd control effects by 10%. Crowd controls can obviously lower your movement speed, so it's really good to be able to fend them off with this resistance. Also, you want to take as little damage as possible. This guy is brilliant for that. If you want to jump around the battlefield and kill things and don't want to be a massive hulking orc, pick the halfling. And finally, but not least, we have the tiefling. The tiefling is quite an odd one, personally. If you play him right, he can probably be one of the best races here if you pick the right class with him. But again, as I said, he's a bit weird. He deals an extra 5% damage to targets below 50% health, which is obviously quite useful. I'd imagine maybe as a rogue, maybe as a control wizard. His ability scores are +2 to charisma, +2 to constitution, or +2 to intelligence. Intelligence is one of the abilities used by control wizards. Charisma, I think, is also used by control wizards and is definitely used by trickster rogues. Infernal Wrath. Whenever you're hit, you have a 10% chance to lower the power of the attacker by 5%. That's quite a utility-based, a utility-based passive. It's quite an odd one to have. I would say he's probably best as a control wizard. Controlling the battlefield, keeping people away from his teammates, and stunning them for as long as possible. He doesn't really want to take much damage himself, which is why it's hard to see why this passive would work with him, but it works. I think it would work quite well as a control wizard. So, that's it. If you want to play a control wizard, you want to play him. Or at least, it would help. So, I hope you enjoyed that quick little round off of all the races and what class would kind of work quite well with them. Again, the all-rounders, human and elf, and then the other ones are a bit more specific. But of course, you can play anyone with anyone, so it doesn't essentially matter. But anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the game.